The reasons behind teen suicide are complex, and the statistics are heartbreaking. Although it's rare among children, the rates of suicide and suicide attempts increase tremendously during adolescence. Dr. Michelle Burke at LA Biomed explores some possible risk factors.
Suicide is a really significant problem among teenagers. In the most recent statistics by the CDC, it's actually the second leading cause of death among 15 to 24 year olds. Some of the common risk factors are depression, difficulties regulating mood, and that in combination with experiencing very stressful life events. So kids from disadvantaged backgrounds may be more at risk for experiencing more significant negative life events. However, you know, that doesn't necessarily put them at higher risk than kids who are from more stable or affluent family situations. We know that sexual abuse is really related to self-harm and suicidal behavior. So any family in which that has occurred or is occurring, that would be an area of concern. In terms of sort of large information about the whole population, Native American adolescents are at the highest risk, and Hispanic adolescents are also at high risk. Generally, suicides among teens occur with kids who are experiencing mental illness or psychopathology. They don't usually occur out of the blue. So kids who are really struggling with depression or other mood disorders are at very high risk. Suicide risk is passed down genetically. So if somebody has a first degree relative who's committed suicide, they're automatically at a much higher risk of committing suicide themselves. There are other behaviors that teens engage in, which involve causing harm to themselves. Some of that would be things like cutting. Some kids also burn themselves, punch themselves. And these kinds of behaviors are things that cause bodily harm, but the teen is not actually intending to kill themselves while doing them. And there's actually recent research showing that what we call non-suicidal self-injury is a big predictor of future suicide attempts. And parents should also take these very seriously and consider having their child evaluated by a mental health professional if they're engaging in those kinds of self-harm behaviors. My advice for a parent who might have concerns that their teen is at risk for suicide are to always take comments about suicide very seriously. So if your child is talking about that, that's a cause for concern, and you should take your child to be evaluated by a mental health professional. If you are concerned about your child, it's also really important to remove any potentially lethal means from your home, which makes it harder for a teen to impulsively do anything to hurt themselves. And there is research showing that removal of means of killing oneself lowers suicide rates. So things like guns, knives, pills, those things should really be removed from your home and secured whenever possible. If you're really concerned your child is in imminent risk of killing oneself or seriously injuring oneself, you should call 911 or take them to the nearest emergency room. And I think the most important thing a parent can do, perhaps overall, is to try and maintain a positive and supportive, accepting, non-judgmental relationship with your teen, because you want your teen to see you as a source of support. And if they're having these kinds of thoughts or other problems, to come and tell you so you can help them. Things get dangerous when kids are keeping things secret or hiding things, so you want to be a resource for your child.
There are many reasons a teen would consider suicide, and it's our job as a parent to keep our children safe. Make sure you listen to them for any warning signs and seek help from a mental health professional if you are concerned your child is at risk. For the American Health Journal, I'm Laura Windsor.